Chapter 49. King Wu in the Red Sand Trap. By order of Burning Lamp, Virtue of the Pure Void rushed to the front. Wang Bian. As you act against the will of heaven, you are doomed. Now that 8 of your traps have been broken, why don't you come to your senses? Heavenly Master Wang was furious. He raised his sword and struck at the immortal, who replied with his own. After several rounds, Wang Bian ran into his red water trap, with the immortal close on his heels. As before, Wang Bian mounted the platform and emptied his gourd onto the ground, flooding the area with red water. When he entered, Pure Void waved his right sleeve, and down dropped a lotus flower for the immortal to float about upon the red water. No matter how violently the red waves churned, no water touched the body of the immortal. Heavenly Master Wang then threw the gourd itself at the immortal, but he was protected by a brilliant cloud that had emerged from his skull. He floated about on the lotus for about 2 hours in perfect safety. Wang Bian knew that he had lost and tried to run away. Pure Void immediately took out his 5 fire and 7 foul fan. The fan could produce 5 kinds of fire: fire from air, stone, wood, earth, and man. And was made of the wings of 7 kinds of fowls, including that green phoenix, rock, peacock, crane, wild swan, and owl. Each wing was stamped with the seals of charms. It was powerful enough to burn rocks to ashes and boil the sea dry. Pure Void fanned Wang Bian once. Wang emitted a single cry before burning to red ash. As the red water trap was destroyed, Pure Void, Burning Lamp, and all the others returned to the pavilion. Grand Tutor Wen became even more depressed. By now, Jiang Ziya had already spent 20 days on Mount Qi, and was ready to put Zhao Gongming to death the following day. In the back camp, Zhao Gongming told Grand Tutor Wen mournfully, "Brother Wen, this is our last meeting. I'll be gone at noon tomorrow." Grand Tutor Wen wept. "It tortures me that I've brought this disaster upon you." Soon Heavenly Master Zhang came to see Zhao Gongming. He hated himself for being powerless to save him from death. They wept to see such a great celestial suffer like a mortal because of Lu Ya's curse and were grieved that his centuries of achievements would end in nothing. At 11 o'clock the next morning, Wu Ji reported to Jiang Ziya that Lu Ya had arrived. Jiang Ziya went out to welcome him, and when they were seated, Lu Ya said, "I should congratulate you, Zhao Gongming will die at noon. What's more, the red water trap has been broken." Jiang Ziya thanked him sincerely. "How could we have ended Zhao's life today without your help?" With a smile, Lu Ya opened his flower basket and took out a small mulberry bow and 3 short peach arrows, which he handed to Jiang Ziya. "Shoot the effigy with the bow and arrows." Lu Ya said, "Shoot his left eye first." Jiang Ziya did as ordered. As the first arrow hit the left eye of the effigy, Zhao Gongming, lying in the Sheng camp, roared in agony and closed his left eye. Grand Tutor Wen held him in his arms, sobbing as the tears poured down his cheeks. The second arrow hit the right eye of the effigy, and the third penetrated its heart. Zhao Gongming died at the third arrow. Seeing that Zhao Gongming was dead, Grand Tutor Wen wailed unrestrainedly. He ordered a grandiose ceremony to mark the encoffining of Zhao's body, and the bier was placed temporarily in the back camp. Zhao's death badly frightened Deng, Zheng, Xin, and Tao. With such highly talented men in the Zhou camp, how can we possibly defeat them? They thought. This affair badly affected the morale of the Sheng army. When Jiang Ziya and Lu Ya returned to the reed pavilion from Mount Qi, all the immortals exclaimed in delight. "Without Brother Lu, how could we have put Zhao Gongming to death so easily?" Before long, Heavenly Master Zhang gave a challenge to the immortals. "The red sand trap is particularly evil. It will take a man greatly blessed by heaven to survive it. Otherwise we'll suffer a major loss." Burning Lamp told Jiang Ziya. "Who can we send, Master?" Jiang Ziya asked. "It's got to be the sage ruler. Anyone else is sure to meet with disaster. Though His Highness is virtuous, He's never learned how to fight. How can he break the trap? Jiang Ziya said doubtfully. We cannot delay. Just ask King Wu to come here. I know how to convince him. Burning Lamp persisted. Jiang Ziya sent Wu Ji to fetch King Wu. When the king arrived, he was met by Jiang Ziya and escorted inside. King Wu bowed to the immortals, who returned the salutation. Master, what instructions would you give me? King Wu asked. We've broken 9 traps, but the red sand, the very last, remains. Only if your highness tackles it can we be assured of success. Is your highness willing to do it? Burning Lamp asked. You've all come here out of compassion for the people. How could I refuse? King Wu replied. Burning Lamp was overjoyed. Would your highness untie your belt and take off your robe? He requested. When King Wu had done so, he drew some charms on the king's breast and back with his middle finger. After he had dressed again, Burning Lamp placed another charm inside the king's dragon crown. Finally, the immortal ordered that Neja and Thunderbolt protect King Wu when he entered the red sand trap. When they came out, King Wu, Neja, and Thunderbolt saw a Taoist emerge from the red sand trap. He wore a fishtail coronet and had a face the color of verdigris and a long red beard. Carrying a pair of swords, he rode a deer toward them singing. Which of you from the Jade Emptiness Palace will meet me? Heavenly Master Zhang Xiao demanded. He then saw Neja and Thunderbolt with a man in a dragon crown, yellow robe, and dragon belt. Who is that coming? It's the sage ruler, King Wu. Neja answered. King Wu trembled at the hideous countenance and ferocious manner of the Heavenly Master, and almost fell from his saddle. Heavenly Master Zhang spurred his spotted deer forward and attacked Neja with his sword. Neja met him with his lance. After a few rounds, Heavenly Master Zhang ran into his red sand trap. Neja, Thunderbolt, and King Wu followed closely on his heels. Heavenly Master Zhang hurriedly mounted his platform, grasped a handful of red sand, and threw it directly at them. King Wu was hit on the breast and tumbled into a huge pit with his horse. Though Neja soared into the air on his wind fire wheels, he was also caught by the red sand and fell into the pit. As the odds were against them, Thunderbolt tried to fly away, but it was too late. He was also knocked into the pit, and all three were trapped by the red sand. Burning Lamp and Jiang Ziya saw only a column of black air rising into the sky. King Wu will be released in 100 days. He, Neja, and Thunderbolt are all destined by fate to suffer this calamity. Burning Lamp reassured Jiang. Jiang Ziya stamped his foot. King Wu is virtuous but still immortal. How can he survive 100 days? What shall we do if something goes wrong? Trust in the will of heaven. King Wu's blessed and will certainly come through. Don't worry, Jiang Ziya. Jiang Ziya went into the city and reported the matter to the palace. Tai Ji and Tai Rin, mother and wife of the king, sent other princes to see Jiang Ziya in his mansion. Jiang Ziya told them definitely that King Wu will come to no harm. He'll merely be trapped in there for about 100 days. He then returned to the reed pavilion and discussed the way with his Taoist friends. Heavenly Master Zhang returned to tell Grand Tutor Wen. King Wu, Neja, and Thunderbolt are all caught in my trap. Though Grand Tutor Wen expressed his delight, he was still deeply grieved at the death of Zhao Gongming. Every day Heavenly Master Zhang threw red sand on King Wu's body to make him feel as if knives were being thrust through him. King Wu, however, was well protected by the charms on his breast and back. As he was blessed, he remained unharmed. Meanwhile, Shen Gongbao had gone to the Three Fairy Island to announce Zhao's death to High Firmament and her sisters. He dismounted when he reached the cave and asked, "Alas, would you please report to your mistress that Shen Gongbao is here?" When Shen was escorted in, High Firmament asked, "Why are you here, brother?"
"I've come about your brother," Shen replied.
"What's so serious that he has to trouble you?"
Don't you know he was shot by Jiang Ziya with charmed arrows on Mount Qi? Shen said with a smile. Green firmament and jade firmament immediately burst into tears. Alas, we never thought that he would lose his life at the hands of Jiang Ziya. Even after he got your golden dragon scissors, he couldn't retrieve his pearls. Before his death, he said to Grand Tutor Wen, "My young sisters are sure to come here for the scissors. Tell them that I regret not following High Firmament's advice. They can see my Taoist robe and silk belt instead of me in person. What a pity that his 1,000 years of cultivation was wasted. My master forbade us to leave the mountain. Anyone who does is certainly on the list of creations. This was destined by heaven. As my brother failed to adhere to these instructions, he was bound to meet with disaster." High Firmament said, "Dear sister, you're too heartless. You say this because you don't want to avenge him. As for the two of us, we must go to see his remains, even if it means that our names are on the list of creations. After all, we are of the same blood." Jade Firmament said angrily. Without another word, Jade Firmament and Green Firmament left the cave and headed for West Qi, one riding a swan, and the other a bird with spotted feathers. They're sure to use the universe muddling dipper. That'll only make things worse. What shall we do then? I must go there too to keep things in hand. High Firmament decided. She ordered her lass to look after the cave, then pursued them on her green phoenix. "Wait for me, sisters. I'm coming too." "Where are you going, sister?" they asked. "As you don't understand how to handle matters properly, I'll come with you to make sure you don't make mistakes." As the three of them flew on, they heard someone calling from behind. "Not so fast, sisters.